Hi everyone, Grailf here again, and in this video I'm going to show you all some tips that I learned when I was leveling up my Moonshiner role, and hopefully some of these can help you guys. These tips are focused at purely trying to get XP as quickly as possible, so we're not really focused on the money side of things here. There's a general sequence of events you can do and to help maximize that until you get to that rank 15 in the Moonshiner role, in which you actually can reduce the time it takes to distill moonshine, and that will actually speed things up, and the last 5 levels can be done a lot quicker than the first 15. And that's it right there, Master Distiller. So what this one does is, for a weak moonshine, it reduces the time taken to make it from 30 minutes down to 24 minutes. It also reduces the time for all the other levels of moonshine as well, but because we're just trying to push out XP, I focused on the weak moonshine because you can do more of them and you can pump them out pretty quickly, and it fits in a lot better with the sequence that I used. So what that basically was I'd start off a moonshine, get some of that batching, then I'd do a bootlegger mission, a story mission, another bootlegger mission, a delivery, and then rinse and repeat, because there's a cooldown between all the different types of missions. Now there's only about 4 or 5 of the story missions. I think there's 5 in total, including the very beginning one, but you can replay 4 of them. So what that means is you can go in, you can do them the first time, and then once you've done the whole lot, you can actually go back and replay them. Now you can change the difficulties into various levels. You can have your normal, hard, or real crazy extreme, and you can do that. You're more than welcome to do that. Something else you can do as opposed to that, because they can take quite a lot of time, and you know you only need a certain amount of time for your cooldown, was when I finished all the story missions, sometimes I might just do a bootlegger and then might go and do like a treasure map in between, you know, like go find a treasure map, or you can go hit a couple collectibles or something and then do another bootlegger, and then you can do your delivery. So you kind of want to sandwich your bootleggers in, like alternating between something. So you'll do like a bootlegger and then like a story mission or a treasure map, and then, or a delivery or something, and then another bootlegger, and then just kind of keep those bootleggers going. Now the bootleggers are good because what they also do is, the more bootleggers you do, it reduces the cost of the mash, which will actually increase your profits. So at the very beginning it costs $50 to make the mash, and you know you put in a bit of flavoring. Now the flavoring I use generally is the berry one, and that's primarily because two of the ingredients you just buy from the catalog pretty easily, and the other one is just raspberries, which are everywhere. So you can just go grab some of them. So what you do is, you know, you increase the flavor so you get a bit more money out of it, but really you're not going to make a great deal of money when you're actually paying $50 in mash. But then again, we're chasing XP here, not money. So what you do is, the more bootleggers you do though, it reduces the cost of the mash. And after a couple of bootlegger missions, as you can see at the end of some of these ones I've got here in the video, it tells you you've reduced the cost of the mash, and after a couple of them it'll drop down to like 30 and so on, sort of thing. Now, one of the other things to remember is that the wagon deliveries, when you're doing those, your honor does play a part in it. So about probably 3 times out of 4, because I'm honorable, like my honor's right up to the max, I will actually get waved through the checkpoints. Some of my friends who are max dishonorable, they pretty much never get waved through, and they get stopped at like every checkpoint. Now this has positives and negatives when you're trying to chase XP, in that if you get waved through, yes, it's a faster way of just getting that mission done so you can get onto the next one. But on the downside, those people there at the checkpoint, every one of them that you shoot is XP that goes towards your Moonshiner role. So you're going to make a fair bit of XP if you actually, you know, get dead eyes, headshot kills, you know, like you can get all the multipliers, you can actually make a fair bit of XP just from taking out those checkpoints. So just keep that in mind, that everything, you know, whenever people you're killing and that sort of stuff in those missions, that it does all count towards your Moonshiner roll XP. So another little tip is you do not want to leave the path because you'll lose all your bottles. So you can jump in cinematic mode, which is pretty good, or you can actually hold your gun out like this and the horses will auto travel on the path, and that will help reduce broken bottles and keep you ready for when those revenue agents try and get you. Using the sequence of events that I was talking about earlier on in the video, each of these deliveries will get you around 847 XP. You'll also earn around, I think it's 200 XP every time you batch up the moonshine and even use the two-star sort of flavoring. And you'll get 50 XP every time the batch is complete. So all up, you're looking at over 1,000 XP there, just in the whole formulating, batching, and delivering of the moonshine. Also, as shown in this video here, I decided to smash a few bottles here just to show you all that you lose money if the bottles don't make it to the end, but your XP will stay the same. As you can see, you can still get your 847 XP, even though we lost 5 bottles, but we lost a fair bit of money in that. Otherwise, I hope everyone enjoyed these tips. There's a few little things I found from my time ranking up as the Moonshiner. You just keep rolling that sequence through, just keep doing bootleg missions and slotting something in between, and just try and keep that XP flowing as best as you can. Then once you rank up to the 20, you can enjoy all the fruits of your bootlegger business. You can get drunk and have the good strong moonshine, and you can dance and party with your band. So otherwise, hope you all enjoy the Moonshiner's update, and keep howling at the moon, outlaws. Thanks, and enjoy.